Giada, Savi, Lindsay, Aryan, Nick, Akansha, Ashi, Ishita, Raj, Arta, Ahana, Arya, Ayush, Meher, Savi, Ganesh, and Raj. Now I would like to call upon Arya and Ganesh to take over the platform. Ladies and gentlemen, Arya and Ganesh.
Campbell.
Sayid.
Campbell Sayid.
Victor and his wife, single old, and three years.
Very good.
Very good. Take one clap, clap, clap. Good job. Good job, Daddy.
Yeah, thank you. Mom,
you're a role model.
Thank you, Sandy. Very nice speech. Now let me call upon on the stage. Let's give a round of applause for our
honey. Remember last time everything went smooth and while taking snap on it so long.
Yeah, yeah.
Great me, my name is Amanda. Dr. John Baker studied elementary education in 1900, dietary Marshall.
Columbia that he experienced equality for the first time.
My name is Arya Balaram. Careers. A Black returning to India, he worked as a dispense secretary for princely state of Baroda. However, the work was not easy for him, as he was often ridiculous and castigated for the untouchable. Quitting the profile of the military minister, he took up job as private tutor and accountant. He even established a consultancy business which doomed due to his social status. He found himself teaching position at the Sydney College of Commerce and Economics in Mumbai. Being a victim of caste discrimination inspired him to uplift the pitiable state of untouchables in the society. Thus, we, with the help of Raja Pumadur, we found a weekly journal, Monai, which quickly set the Oxford belief of Hindus and the politicians to fight the discrimination. Accumulating enough wealth, he moved to London to complete his education. In 1921, he attained his master's degree from London School of Economics. 2 years later, he acquired his D.C.S. in economics. Completing his law studies, he was admitted to the British Bar as a barrister. Returning to India, he was starting working as a legal professor in the country. His passion for the practice of caste discrimination led him to found the Bhatrika Sabha. The main aim of the organization was to bring an education and soul community improvement to the practice. In 1925, he was appointed to the Mumbai Presidency Committee to work under the All-European Standards Commission. The commission reports were prepared by the conference to set up in its own version of the Constitution of the Free India. Thank you, Arya, for the amazing speech. Now let's call Arya Kozo.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Arya Kozo and I am Dick Frey. Today I'm going to speak about why Baba Sahib chose Buddhism. And if Buddha and his Dhamma, Baba Sahib said, I regard the Buddha's Dhamma to be the best. No religion can be compared to it. If a modern man knows science must have a religion, only religion he can have is the religion of Buddha. When Baba Sahib was a young boy, his father made him read Mahabharata and Ramayana every day. He read it to his sisters and people who assembled at their house to hear the talk. He did this for many years but never liked it. He always had a question for his father. His father answered to the number of sailors had school. When he passed the fourth grade English exam, people from his community were very happy. They wanted to celebrate and congratulate him in a public meeting. But his father was against this meeting and found it just as good as they all sound for celebrating. People who wanted to celebrate were disappointed. They went to Dhamma because his father was his father's wife. He intervened and the meeting was held.
Yeah.
event gave us a life of dignity and equality. Jay. Thank you, Aryan. That was wonderful of you. Now I would like to call Ayush on the stage. Please welcome him with a round of applause.
Please welcome her with a round of applause.
Jay, everyone. My name is
decision to convert, Dr. Ambi would tell his followers, so long as you remain in your religion, which teaches a man to treat another man like a lover, the sense of discrimination on account of caste, which is deeply rooted in our minds, cannot grow. For annihilating caste and untouchables, change of religion is the only antidote.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Suresh Pajwani, and I hope to answer the question, is Buddhism good for us? Buddhism comes from Buddha, and Buddha means who is having knowledge of everything. We all know that he is a human and emotionless of nature, becoming free from suffering. If I start telling, there will be no end. So in Buddhism, there is no God, so we don't have to follow rituals. For following it, you first investigate and then believe. In this technique, we have to train our mind because it is a source of our suffering and joy. No one can perform the rituals for you. You have to do it by yourself. This technique is highly pragmatical. It is open, possessive, and not institutional. Buddhism is making people more aware, caring, skillful. It makes you mindful, calmer, happier, and calm. Thank you.
Thank you, Vinesh. That was a very brilliant speech. Now, our next speaker is Ishika. Please put your hands together for Ishika.
Hello, my name is Ishika Sojana, and I'm in fifth grade. Today, I'll be talking about the four qualities of love. The teachings on love given by the Buddha are clear, scientific, and applicable. Love, compassion, joy, and equality are the very nature of an enlightened person. They are the four aspects of true love within ourselves and within everyone and everything. If we learn ways to practice love, compassion, joy, and equality, we will know how to heal the illness of anger, sorrow, insecurity, sadness, loneliness, and unhealthy attachment. Love, compassion, joy, and equanimity are the very nature of an enlightened person. They are the four aspects of true love within ourselves and within everyone and everything. The first aspect of true love is metta, the intention and capacity to offer joy and happiness. To develop the capacity, we have to practice looking and listening deeply so that you know what to do and what not to do to make others happy. If you offer your beloved something she does not need, that is not meant to be. You have to see her real situation or what you will offer might bring her unhappiness. Compassion. The second aspect of true love is karuna. The intention and capacity to relieve and transform suffering and enlighten sorrows. Karuna is usually translated as compassion, but that is not exactly correct. Compassion is composed of calm together with, and passion is suffering. But we do not need to suffer to remove suffering from other person. Doctors, for instance, can relieve their patient's suffering without experiencing the same pain in themselves. If we suffer too much, we may be crushed and unable to help. Still, until we find a better word, let's use compassion to translate clinically. Joy. The third element of true love is mudita, joy. True love always brings joy to ourselves and to the ones we love. If our love does not bring joy to both of us, it's not true love. Commentators explain that happiness relates to both body and mind, whereas joy relates to primarily to mind. Equanimity. The fourth element of true love is upeksha, which means equanimity. Not attachment, even minus, or letting go. Upa means over, and iksha means to love. You climb the mountain to be able to look over the whole situation, not bound by one side or the other. If your love has attachment, discrimination, or clinging in it, it's not true love. Without a fix shot, your love may become positive. This is intervening nature for the poor immeasurable ones. We must look deeply and practice love for ourselves to bring these four aspects of love into our own lives and into the lives of those we love.
Thank you. आगे जाओ आगे ये हो रहा है ना अब देख लो स्माइल एवरीबॉडी
वन टू थ्री स्माइल ओके जब 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 जब
Good job.
Okay, guys. Okay.